Meanwhile, more reason for the government to worry. Oil prices continue to climb higher, making the threat of inflation even more severe. Rajkumar Sahu files this report on the options before the government.
International crude prices now crossed $90 per barrel, and so subsidy paid by the oil companies for diesel, LPG and kerosene are now at worrying levels. And at $90, the under-recoveries may be as high as 70,000 crore rupees for the whole fiscal. The Empowered Group of Ministers, or EGOM, on fuel prices is likely to meet on 30th of December, but with government also having to grapple with the rising onion prices and inflation moving up, the question is if they can afford to hike the prices of diesel, LPG and kerosene. Any fuel price hike means giving more ammunition to the opposition, which is taking on the government on the issues of corruption and price rise. But if the government doesn't hike the prices, then the health of the oil companies will deteriorate and even endanger the proposed follow-on public issues of oil companies like ONGC. But then, what can government do, if not to hike fuel prices? As even reducing duty on the crude and petroleum products before budget has been rejected by the finance ministry. So, how will the subsidy burden be shared?
Something is contributed by the government, a part is contributed by the upstream companies, ONGC, Oil India and GAIL, and a balance, a small proportion, would also be absorbed by the oil marketing companies. This is how the system has worked over the last few years. There is absolutely no thinking on the part of the government for any intervention in the pricing of petrol.
As the meeting of the Empowered Group of Ministers approaches, compensating oil companies in cash seems to be the only option for the government, though an expensive option that comes at the cost of denting the exchequer, but a better option than inviting further public ire over rising prices. In New Delhi, Rajkumar Sahu, NDTV Profit.